Indianapolis Colts mandatory minicamp starts today. Had a chance to catch up with Anthony Richardson, quarterback. A lot of expectations for Anthony Richardson. He's got expectations for himself. He's also got, I think, a unique level of humility, and he's also got a sense of humor, as you're going to see.
Sammy, just what's been your impression so far of kind of this lifestyle, being an NFL quarterback, being in this building, running an offense? How's it measured up to kind of what you thought this would be?
I'm just here, so I want to be fine. No, I told my wife I'm gonna do that. But it's been everything I dreamed of. You know, it's a lot of work. And when I say a lot of work, I mean a lot of work. You know, just being here with the vets, just working, watching them work, and then just trying to find my own routine within everything, and just grind day in, day out. You know, everything I dreamed of, but it definitely is a lot.
Have things slowed down for you from day one to now? I mean, to where you're just not overwhelmed, or did you ever feel overwhelmed? Have things slowed down for you?
Oh, things have definitely slowed down. It was my first day practicing with the vets. It was way different from rookie minicamp. You know, I just see guys flying around. I pulled the ball on the zone read one time, and the end was chasing me. He was like right next to me. I'm like, okay, this is different. So it was definitely going fast, but the next day I noticed some progress, and I was just relaxing and just trusting what I was studying. But it's definitely slowed down for me.
People have been saying they've seen you coming out of your shell a little bit, getting more comfortable. Are you feeling that now? Is it starting to feel more like home?
Oh yeah, definitely. You know, the main thing when it comes to that is just finding a routine, you know, finding my place in the building, finding what I need to work on, get advice from the vet, and just understand what they want from me. You know, sometimes I have to remember that I am a rookie and I don't know everything, and I have to, you know, just trust the process. But it's just a matter of getting information and just being myself and just finding my routine.
How much do you grow from the mistakes that you make? You go back and you watch on tape and you have all the time in the world to study. Do you grow a lot from those?
I feel like you have to. You know, this game, you know, the margin of error is so small, and playing against pros, so mistakes, you have to limit them. Nobody's perfect, you're gonna make mistakes, but you have to learn from mistakes. You know, I'm constantly trying to, you know, get information, learn from my mistakes, just so I can, you know, do my job the best I can for the team.
How will you spend the next month and a half before the game?
You know, I'll be getting with the receivers, you know, getting with Gardner, trying to get in the building here so I can, you know, just constantly get my information and just build chemistry, because the season's right around the corner. You know, it's coming up fast. I was just trying to just get better, master my craft, get in the playbook a lot more, get chemistry with receivers a lot more as well.
Talk about the margin for error. How much have you learned about the margin for error in the red zone for the NFL, and some of those looks when it comes to just how accurate, how precise you have to be to score in those situations?
I've learned a lot. First red zone day, you know, I realized how small the windows were and how fast the defense can react to certain things. One minute, you think, oh, that's an easy touchdown, I got him. And you throw it, it's a little late. DB just reacts to it. So I definitely have realized that the margin of error is definitely small. So it's just a matter of mastering my craft and just being ahead of the defense whenever the time comes.
Kenny Moore was just saying that he's observed you, like, really studying your notes in the mornings before meetings and that kind of thing. How have you approached it from that perspective? Because, I mean, just showing up and doing the bare minimum is not going to be enough, right?
Right.
So what have you done that way?
One, my position in the life that I'm in, you know, I can't do the bare minimum. You know, the team would not allow that. I would not allow that for myself. And I know GM, coach, the owners definitely don't want that for me. So it's just a matter of me just putting the work in, you know, and I'm not just doing it for show.
Yeah.
You know, because I actually want to learn this information, know this information for the team, because I don't want to get thrown out there and I'm lost and the team's like, why is this dude out there? So I just want to make sure I'm on point with everything, and I'm doing my job the best way I can.
Anthony, how are you fitting into Shane's offense?
I'm loving it. You know, day in, day out, you know, I'm studying it, looking at it, asking questions every day, just trying to get advantages, you know, because defenses, I know they're going to prepare for our offense, so I'm just trying to make sure I can do it the best way I can, and when the time does come, you know, we're beating them because they can't stop us.
They had a couple of former greats come back and talk to you all, the rookies. Last number four pick in particular, Edwin James, what was it like to just interact with him and pick his brain?
You know, whenever any NFL legend, former player, anybody that has been in this situation can only speak to you. You always want to listen and open up ears, but they've been through the process before. Like, we're new to this. I'm talking about the rookies. We're new. We don't really know much. So getting information from them, you know, especially Hall of Famers, you know, that's something you know, you need to pay attention to, because you know, eventually you want to be in that person's shoes, and they want to win championships and just be the best version of yourself.
Anthony, have you moved here now? I mean, is this home now, or are you still is Gainesville still right now your home?
I feel like this is home. You know, I got me a spot. Sleep there, you know, wake up there. So it definitely feels like home. I try to visit Gainesville whenever I can to see my family, see my friends and stuff. But you know, this is home, and you know, I'm trying to make it home forever.
How much have you seen beyond Walgreens at this point?
That is a great question. I did go bowling, and I went to a hibachi spot, but I haven't seen much. You know, just seen my playbook a lot, and I think it's gonna be like that for a while.
Shane wouldn't say, but did y'all get a rematch in bowling? If so,
who won? Okay. He did beat me at one time, but we didn't get a rematch yet. And I'm going to rematch when I bring my ball up here, because I do have a ball, and I didn't have my ball then. And I was used to playing my ball, so I'm going to get him.
When you do look at the playbook, what excites you about some of the nuances that are in there for you?
I don't know. As a QB, we never see deep shots in the playbook. You know, you get excited because you like to throw the ball deep, beat the coverage whenever it does happen. But I just get excited when I'm looking at it in general, because it's all new to me. And I'm like, okay, what's this? Gotta ask questions. Coach, how does this relate to this? And what happens if they do this? So just getting information and just taking it in, I just love it.
What is hard to get to your development? He was saying, like, you told him after that first day, man, this is fast. How much has he helped you just adjust to life in the NFL?
You know, he's been through it. Sam's been through it. You know, they just help me stay calm. You know, as a rookie, especially QB, you know, it's a lot. And you will see it as too much. And they just help me, you know, stay sane and just, like, it's all part of the process. We've all been through it. We all want to know everything, but we can't, you know, so it's just a matter of learning and going through those practices where it does seem too fast for me. And I do make mistakes here and there. You know, it's like, okay, I made this mistake because of that, and I have to fix it, you know, in the future.
Talk about how much you're trying to learn the offense. I mean, how much does it help to have Gardner, who's kind of been in this with Shane already, just as someone who in the room can kind of help you go through it?
It helps a lot, because you know, not only me asking questions to Coach Shane, you know, I can talk to Gardner, I can talk to Sam, because he's running a similar offense as well. So just talking to them, you know, they help, you know, simplify it for me. You know, Coach is going to teach it the way he does, and you know, as a QB that's played in the offense, you know, he might see it a little different because he's on the field. So just getting information from Gardner and Sam, you know, it's definitely helpful. It keeps me sane.
Ultimately, you want to be the starting quarterback here. I know, you know, whatever happens, but what do you think will be the determining factor in you getting that opportunity at some point? What do you think is going to get you there specifically?
Honestly, I'm not sure. You know, I guess it's whenever Coach Steichen feels like I'm ready, right, you know, to be out there. You know, he's confident that I know the stuff, confident I can lead the team, and confident I can win NFL games. So it's just a matter of him, you know, feeling like I'm ready or not, and just me trying to make sure every day.
And when you find that balance between, like, giving yourself grace for the things you don't know, but also, like, that competitive fire where it's like, man, I want to know it tomorrow. Like, how do you find that balance?
And I talk to Coach Jimbaugh, Coach Cam, and Coach Steichen about it all the time. You know, I ask them, like, am I good? Like, am I behind on anything? I just have to remember that I'm a rookie, you know. I want to learn everything. I want to know everything, like, right now. And I tell them, like, I want to know everything, but I can't because I haven't seen everything. I haven't even played my first game yet. So it's just a matter of remembering that I'm a rookie, but also just, you know, making sure that I can be the best rookie there is. So that's really it.
Anthony, on the outside, so many people want to talk about, like, your athleticism as a quarterback, upside, your arm, but I guess in time, what do you hope people will think about when they think about you?
Hopefully, I just think that I'm a great quarterback, you know, despite, you know, all the things I can do physically. You know, God blessed me with that, and I'm thankful. But, you know, the game isn't always physical. You Like I said earlier, playing against pros, those guys are physically gifted as well. You know, everybody's running 4.4s, 4.5s, 4.6s. So just because I'm fast doesn't mean I can just run around people because they're fast as well. So this is, I just want to get mentally better every day and go out there and play quarterback and not just be a freak athlete that knows how to throw the ball far.
All right. Thanks, everyone.
Thank you.
Appreciate you.
Thank you, y'all.
That's Anthony Richardson. And Mike Chappell said it as he walked out of the room a minute and a half ago. He said, I hope he's the real deal. And he seems like the real deal. It seems like the humility is genuine. It seems like he's just a guy who wants to get as good as he can get and is going to do whatever it takes to get there. And that's the hope. You hope that that's what he winds up. And if he does do that, if he's diligent and he keeps grinding day after day after day after day, and he has the acumen to understand exactly what's going on and process it quickly, he's going to be pretty good, and he's going to be pretty good sooner rather than later.